everyone, I'm Jane. I'm in my last year of engineering physics here at UBC, and today I'll be taking you through a day in my life here at UBC. It's 9:50 a.m. in the morning right now, and I'll be heading over to my first class, which is Physics 403, Statistical Mechanics.
You've all probably heard before that the engineering schedule is pretty crazy. This is what a typical first-year UBC engineering student's timetable looks like. And this is probably the hardest timetable that I've ever personally taken here at UBC. You can see that the day is pretty packed with lectures. It can be pretty hard to manage all the classes and homeworks that you have, but with good time management and with practice, it's definitely possible. I really believe the holy grail for taking notes is to do it on an iPad or a tablet of some sort. Ignore me pulling out a paper and pen here, I'm working on a cheat sheet for a quiz that has to be in paper. But basically, I started my degree using paper and pen to take notes and switched to an iPad halfway through, and it really changed everything for me. One of the most effective ways for me to take notes is to make a summary sheet of everything that I've learned. You can see some examples that I've done here for classes that I'm taking this term. Not only is this a great way to study for exams, but I also feel it helps me do my homework so much faster because everything that I need to refer to is in one place.
So I just finished that quiz and it was honestly kind of a doozy, but it's done, so I'm not going to think about it. So that means I'm done for the day in terms of classes, but I have quite a few assignments and lectures to catch up on, so I'll be at school still studying for the rest of the day. But first, I'm going to get lunch with my friend.
Another lazy afternoon, the clouds covered in gray, third coffee of the day.
So now this is the part of the day that I set aside to get some homework done. Time management is a really crucial part of being an engineering student, and here are some of the things that I've learned throughout my degree. The first thing is that you can't rely on motivation and willpower alone to get your studies done. That's only going to get you so far. The bulk of your studying is going to have to be due to habits that you build up over time and discipline. Planning and time blocking are effective ways to make sure that work gets done. I also personally disable notifications and have time limits on all of my social media apps.
So I just got off the bus and I'm walking home now. It's around 6:10 right now. So it's been a really long day, but I still have a work-learn meeting from 7 to 8 later. So I'll be doing that.
So I just got home and I'm going to make a quick like soup noodle dish for dinner. I just finished my work-learn meeting and it's now 8:20 p.m. and I'm exhausted, but I'm still gonna go play badminton tonight, so let's go!
I wake up, I don't wanna make my bed, I save up all my energy, instead you take up all the energy I have inside.
I'm back from badminton now and I've showered and it's 12:30, so it's pretty late, but I am teaching a tutorial tomorrow morning and I kind of have to do the tutorial problem to make sure I know what I'm doing, so I'll do that now before I sleep.
So by now you can see there's quite a few options for having part-time jobs at UBC. For example, I'm doing work learn and also being a TA. Some other options include being a note taker for some of the classes. And it's really great to have your part-time job be at UBC because you're at school anyways.
So that's it for today. I just finished and it is now 12:42 and I should be going to bed. Thanks for watching. That was a day in the life of an engineering student at UBC. And make sure to like and follow Eng Stories if you want to see more content.
But I'm not ever wishing on a star that galaxies won't make you change.